statue. Liberty started shaking her fist, and the eagle will fly, and it's gonna be here. I brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue.
It's time for Veterans Issues, the show that brings you information about veterans, military, and their families. Now here's your host, Ken Rollins.
Welcome to Veterans Issues. Ken Rollins here. Today's guest is Mike Abrams, excuse me, and Wayne Baker. And we're going to be talking about the Veterans Day, November the 11th, coming up. We got a lot of things to talk about. Get you a pen. Welcome back to Veterans Issues. Ken Rollins here. Appreciate you tuning in today. Appreciate you tuning in every day. I don't even know what day of the week y'all watching this, but whatever day it is, it's a good one. As I told you earlier, Mike Abrams is on, and Wayne Baker. And every year we have the Veterans Day ceremony along, followed by the parade. The parade seems to be getting bigger and bigger every year, and so we're going to talk about that and give you something to look forward to on November the 11th. Welcome to the show.
Hello, Ken.
It's been you a long time. Good to meet you, Wayne.
Same here.
My first time to meet Wayne. I've known you for 4 years.
It's been a while.
You were just a little bitty fella. No. I know. Those of you don't know, this guy, he's been around here in this area meaning Anniston, Oxford, all. He is at Fort McClellan, a public affairs officer. He's also a public affairs at the depot for a while.
Doing what
that's
I can
what,
to
that's
help.
That's what you keep, do, ain't it?
Yep.
And that's because you speak the English language. You know that? That's what we do. We get these jobs because we can. We were talking earlier about the girl. Now everybody that's watching me has watched Dr. Phil. When I say catch me outside, how about that? You know exactly what I'm saying, don't you? Catch me outside, how about that? That's another language. Hey, I got another language that you got kids, Wayne?
Oh yes, got three.
Let me give you a little trick that you can pull on your kid. Are they teenagers?
Oh, they're grown, they're fully grown.
Well, you still get them. It's a table, write down. She looks like a idiot. He looks like he ain't got no sense. You can write that about your boy and your girl in cursive. And a lot of kids can't even read it because the school wouldn't teach them cursive writing. You know, like we write.
Right.
We can write cursive. Like some kids can't. We got it on them. It's like Russian to them. We say, look how stupid that hair looks. They don't know what you said. You just smile when you write it. So that's something we got on the kids. You folks can use that too. Them kids that don't do cursive. But anyhow, with that said, let's talk about Veterans Day. I'm gonna go over you, Mike, first. What year is this that you've been doing this parade?
I've been helping with the parade for many years. And it's just something that with people like Wayne, it's just a passion of ours to make sure that the veterans in the community, people like you and Wayne and me and all the others who have served, have a forum to strut their stuff, if you will, just to stand up straight, throw their chest out, and be proud again, proud of their service.
I used to do it way back there years ago, and I'm going to tell you, it make a young man old real quick, because people don't realize all the nuts and bolts it takes to put one together.
That's correct.
From picking your,
the Grand Marshal.
Grand Marshal. You can hurt feelings by doing that, because why didn't he pick me, Gunner? And especially when you've got a community that used to have whack, because if you pick a Sergeant Major whack and you got a colonel there, somebody's going to get the feelings hurt. And believe me, I have dealt on the other end, on the receiving end of some of our fine whack. And they wanted me to, they want me to recognize them up at the park. And I tell them, ladies, I don't see you any different than I did myself. And be blessed by that, because I don't want you to stand out like you were a different branch of service. You are a woman's Army Corps. I was in the men, and it's so different. We blended together. I served with a bunch of you overseas in Germany and elsewhere and Vietnam. But I don't distinguish between that. But they got mad. They want to be recognized for the Women's Army Corps. You know what I'm talking about. And I got myself chewed out quite a few times for that. So putting a parade together, is you got all these things to take into consideration. But the one thing I learned the hard way is don't put the horses in the front. Don't let the horses lead, because the sheriff's department had the horses out there 1 year, and they decided they wanted to carry the flags in the front. Well, guess what they drop in the front?
Got to watch where you step.
And the guys with the white boots on behind them was having a fit. And my bagpipe player was one of those people. And he was having a walk in it. And so he cleaned his feet off and got in my vehicle and rode with me the rest of the way. But anyhow, parades are a challenge at the least. And I ain't heard nothing from the booth up there. Is MJ still here with us, Jeff? Did he tell him? Okay, I was wondering if he's going to tell me how much time we got, because we run over. I'll go on into tomorrow. I'll be sitting right here tomorrow morning. So anyhow, this your first year, Wayne?
No, I've been dealing with the parade for 20 years or more.
No, I mean the parade.
Correct.
Tell really?
20, yes, sir.
Okay, so you was working with Ben Cunningham and that bunch?
Ben Cunningham, Linda Peters, Mike Abrams.
We're all still involved, and the parade, because of the hard work of people that you just mentioned, not only Wayne Baker, but Linda Peters, Ben Cunningham, Larry Smith, there are a lot of folks who have put their heart and soul into making sure that every year Anniston does have a good parade.
That's correct.
When Desert Storm started, Linda and her sister, Lisa, contacted me and said, is there something we can do to honor the Desert Storm troops? They're not going to be here, but can we do something to honor them? I said, yeah, we'll just have a little parade for them. So we started up here at 17th and we come on down. We had about 3,000 people show up for it. She said, is there something we can do? And I said, yeah, call the White House. And she said, what? I said, call the White House. Just Google it and find a number. Call the White House and tell them you want George Bush to send you a letter. Tell them what you're doing. You're having a parade and all that stuff. You want to send a letter from George Bush supporting it. Can we do that? Yes. I said, do it. Next thing you know, they got a letter from George Bush. They were so excited. That was Linda's first delve into doing something like this. And so we got the letter and we read his letter at the event. So we got to go to a break. Got to make some money. So get your pen. We'll be right back. And welcome back. Did you get this? This is a flyer from the, you probably got a better one up there at the MJ. That's showing what we're talking about, 2024 Veterans Day. Right, what's that? See the loyalty and service. Yeah, that's a good deal. Anyhow, if you're wondering what the dates is again, 11, 11, and 11. In the South, a Southern boy would say 11, 11, 11. And that would be November the 11th at 11 o'clock. I have the ceremony in the park, and then I believe the parade starts at 2.
That's correct.
At 2 o'clock, after you go to the service up in the park, a couple blocks over, from Quintard over to Noble, is the parade. Parade starts at what, 17th?
Starts at 15th Street.
It starts at 15.
Starts at 15 and ends on 9th.
Well, I thought it was gathered in there by the county commission and all that.
Right, that's the stage in there.
That's 17. Mm-hmm. That's 1702 Noble Street, yeah.
Staging area by the Anniston City Meeting Center.
And then
we'll get started right at 2 o'clock.
But you don't do anything up at commission, the commission office is anymore?
No.
Okay.
Registration.
Registration, as Wayne just said, we will register all the people who are going to be in the parade behind the Calhoun County Commission office.
All right.
And then we'll start at 15th Street.
And this is for either one of you. Somebody's out there watching right now, they got something they want to put in the parade. If you thinking you got your granddaughter wants to dress up in red, white, and blue and parade down the street, who would they contact? Wayne?
Well, you could contact the email to Calhoun County Veteran.
You email Calhoun County Veterans.
Yes, at gmail.com. And you can request an entry form.
Or you can
call Linda Peters at 256-591-3093. And she will get you a form and tell you how to get it.
I got all that stuff here and I didn't even know I had it. Calhoun County Veterans at gmail.com. Calhoun County Veterans at gmail.com. And so if you want to be in the parade, you got something you want to put in the parade, are you having like old cars and stuff like that?
We expect that there will be a number of old-time vehicles, Corvettes. We may even see a vehicle or two from Anniston Army Depot. There may be some law enforcement and fire department vehicles in the parade. But it's an opportunity for everybody who's interested to bring their motorcycles, bring their cars, bring their trucks. We may even see the tiny vehicles of the Shriners. We'll see.
Oh, yeah, they see them. I enjoy them a lot. That's you know, talking about the horses. Don't put the horse at the front now. I just think it's something else. If you got Teslas in there, you might want the fire department right behind them.
Mm-hmm. Well, we won't worry about that. I'm sure that all the vehicles in the parade will crank, run, and get to the end of the parade.
But if they were to catch on fire like Teslas are known to do, wouldn't that be a sight for the parade?
We anticipate, Ken, we anticipate good weather, okay. No heavy rains, no floods, and we'll enjoy a good day on Monday, November 11th, starting at 2 o'clock for the parade. Of course,
well,
people will be downtown. People will be downtown for the ceremony at 11 a.m., but then after lunch, come on over to Noble Street and enjoy the parade.
You notice
with the
I always put a tent up, though. At my service, that's optimistic, or I'd be a pessimist to do that. But anyhow, you're going to have a full day of patriotism, what I call it. This is a day for the veterans. Memorial Day is for those that didn't get to be veterans. That's the difference between the two of them. Those that didn't make it are for Memorial Day. So this is one for to celebrate the veterans. And have you picked your
Grand Marshal?
Grand Marshal. Have you picked him?
We have selected. We had a meeting the other night, and we have asked three World War II veterans to be our Grand Marshal.
Well, they got to be 100 years old or more.
They are, and they were in the parade last year, and they're going to be up front in the parade in front of the horses in a special antique automobile, convertible. And those three veterans, two Navy and one Army, and it will be Harsel Durham, Ralph Byerly, and Plemmer East, people who many in the community already know, but they served in the military during World War II, and they have agreed to be the Grand Marshal for the 2024 Veterans Day Parade right here in Anniston.
I want you folks out there to listen to what he's saying. What is this? What kind of day is that?
It is Veterans Day, November 11th.
I just wanted to say veterans, because how many times have you seen these senators, these congressmen on television, and these presidents saying, I support veterans, all veterans. There is no such thing as a veteran. There's no Veterans Day. There's no Veterans Cemetery. It's veterans. He's saying it. I want you to listen to it. Y'all pick it up. It's like people down here say Calhoun is C-O-W. H-O-O-N, Calhoun. Ain't got no L in it at all. Calhoun, I'm Calhoun County. Some of my buddies today, I'm from Calhoun County. Anyhow, go on, what else that we got to do that I need to be remember about the parade?
Well, just to contact the committee via Calhoun County Veterans at gmail.com or call Linda Peters at...
What's that phone number?
256-591-3093. And between the email and the phone call, we'll make sure that everyone who wants to be in the parade will get one of the application forms, and we'll make sure that they can help this community celebrate the veterans who live with us around Calhoun County.
I'm going to...
And if by chance, though, Ken, if I can, if sure. by chance, if they forget and do not get a form and get it in time, just go behind the administration building, like you said, on 18th Street.
About where you get your tag.
Correct. And just sign in with old Ben Cunningham back there, and you can still get in the parade the day of the parade.
Well, I'm going to go over you guys here. I'm going to let everybody, in Calhoun and Etowah, the St. Clair County, I'm going to invite them to be in the parade. They're going to be on the sidelines watching the parade, but when them cameras hit, they're going to show them on the sideline. They're going to be on TV and everywhere else, newspaper, having their picture taken, standing on the sidelines, saluting when the flag goes by or whatever. So everybody that's watching, I'm inviting you to go on the 11th at 2 o'clock, 11 at 2, to be down there on the side of Noble Street, smiling, wear your best dress, wear your patriotic colors, and watch what happens. You're going to end up being on television that night, or you're going to be on in a newspaper. You'll see Bill Wilson, somebody in the Anderson Star, running around with a camera, and hey, you're going to take your picture, you're going to put you in the Anderson Star. So I'm inviting everybody. Do you get that?
Yes.
Everybody. Y'all with me now?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Everybody,
that's why we're with you on Veterans Issues, to get the word out, because we know that people listen
to Ken Rollins. I hear you to the pen. But I tell you what we're going to do, just because you said that's sucking up. I'm gonna go to a break. Normally, I'd come back, got some stuff to do. Normally, I'm going to come back. Instead of doing my normal stuff, I'm going to come back to you guys. Let's go to a break. Get the pen. Welcome back to Veterans Issues. I'm sitting here with Wayne Baker and Mike Abrams. Thought I forgot the name, but I didn't. Mike and I go back about 12 miles, man.
More like 14 and a half.
14. Anyhow, let's talk more about November the 11th. Everything we got to talk about. Wayne, you hear something, you step in.
Okay, I will.
Okay. You don't have anything, right? Anything additional that we left out? I know we left out something.
Well, it's just a perfect opportunity for people to come out and appreciate all the hard work that people like Linda Peters, Ben Cunningham, Wayne Baker, and the others have done every year, spend the better part of the year getting ready for the parade. We know it takes you quite a bit of effort to get the ceremony at Centennial Park done, and likewise for the parade, to marshal all those resources to make sure that the Anniston Police Department, Anniston Fire Department, the Anniston administration is all keyed in, all on the same sheet, and Calhoun County as well. And the other person that, the other organization that is always very, very supportive of the parade is the Elks Lodge on South Noble.
They sure are. And I noticed something too. You have a good support from the city of Anniston.
Yes.
They really, Jackson Hodges and all that bunch, they really support you. And they talk about it a lot. They're really good to have, but you know, in this day that we're talking about, this time period in our lives, we need to get out there and show what the veterans have done. Because, you know, I'm dealing with some stuff down in Montgomery. People that watch this show know what I'm doing with our governor and some others on the staff down there. But what the problem is, y'all might can relate to this, these department heads whether it's transportation or others, and I'm not talking on anyone, I'm not going to mention it, they have no idea what a veteran is. They don't know a veteran. They think like a veteran cheerleader or a veteran whatever. They don't know what a veteran that served in combat is. That don't mean nothing to Purple Heart. But they really don't, and I can't blame them. They just don't know. A lot of these people that's working for our governor that make decisions, big decisions, wasn't even born when 9/11 happened, and I'm serious.
Right.
They're in their 20s. They don't have any idea when, and some of them were born, but they were only a year old or 2 years old, so they're not privy to what we're dealing with. So they see me in the newspaper here lately. I'm at odds with our governor, but about veterans. But this is a time to honor veterans, and that's what the people, you know, people got a thing of saying, especially politicians, oh, I support veterans. I put them on the spot and I said, well, what do you do? And you ought to see what happens when I ask that question. And I could name you some senators I asked that to at one of the parties they pitched for the veterans in Montgomery, the wine and dine thing, and I was there. And every time the senator, I support veterans. Said, what do you do, Senator? What do you do? I'd like to know what the program you got. They walk away. Well, they say we got to run. So all of y'all veterans, so let's give these folks out there a salute, and we'll see you on November the 11th, coming down Noble Street. You be there or else.